looking at right now? Give us a play-by-play. What are we looking at right now, Lieutenant?
So right now we've got one of our paramedics in talking to the patient, and what they're doing is they're just trying to spread that wall enough to gain access to her and to be able to slide her out. They're using lubricants. They're using lubricants to try to make her more slippery so that they can slide her over and get her out of that door.
What about those airbags? We saw those go down as well. Tell us a little bit again about what those are doing.
Right. The airbags are in between the wall and the building, and the idea there is that they're capable of lifting cars, so they're very strong airbags. The idea there is that we're going to spread this wall that we've created relief cuts in away from the building and make enough space so that we can...
Looks like they're also, I can see they've cut away her shirt. Is that also to just try and get her, create more room to get her out?
Exactly. As you can imagine, with a wall like this, it's a very rough surface. So anything you can do to create more space and not have a snag there is worth it.
Are your crews pretty confident that they're going to be able to get her out through this hole here within the next few minutes? We watched the paramedics ready to get her out. I mean, what's your estimation on how long this could take?
You know, like I said before, these operations are so fluid, it's hard to say, but that's the hope. You can see that they're using that bottle there, and that's lubricant to try to make her more slippery. So it's just a slow, steady operation. So I don't have a good estimate on how long it's going to take, but I'd imagine, you know, it could be any time now.
I would imagine, too, there's concern with trying to pull her out that you don't want to injure her while you're doing that.
Exactly. We don't want to make her injuries worse, and that's the main thing. So we just want to get her out as safely as we can, but... it's obviously scary for her, so she's in a hurry to get out, but we want to do it as safely as we can.
If for some reason this doesn't work, what would be plan B?
You know, there's a lot of different plans they could do. They could cut a hole above and just pull that wall away like we talked about initially. They've got a lot of options at this point with having such good access to her. So they'll continue to try this for a little while, and I think they've got a pretty good chance of this working, but they've got a lot of different plans.
How long will they continue to do this? Wiggle back and forth to try and get her out.
Well, I mean, it looks like at this point she's getting closer, so I think they'll keep doing it as long as they're making forward progress.
Okay, thank you. Again, that's Lieutenant Damon Simmons with Portland Fire and Rescue giving us an update on what they're doing right now. You heard about the lubricants, the airbags, doing anything possible to create room. I just walked around the corner, guys, and I could see her arm, her forearm as well as part of her upper arm. They've cut away her shirt to try and get gain more access to her and get her out.
That's a reporter on the scene from KPTV Television in Portland, Oregon. And we've been watching this now for about an hour and 20 minutes.
It's fascinating. You know, it must be terrifying for her.
And we said at the outset, we have never quite seen a story like this before. And so you're watching it along with us. She still has her eyeglasses on.
Yeah.
After being inside that nook for, 4 hours plus now? 8 inches wide, apparently fell in this area at 3 o'clock in the morning.
You know, I think it's reassuring that she seems to be using her arm to kind of grab that side wall, which would indicate, hopefully,
like
that there's no serious spinal injury or anything of that type. We're seeing the top of her face right now. This is unbelievable. She's trying
relieved.
To get herself out now.
And she's got a smile on her face.
This guy's been working with her. Boy, are they going to be friends for the rest of their lives, right? I mean, this woman has been, he's been talking her through this whole thing. And, of course, we're all still wondering what the heck she was doing up on that wall in the middle of, at 3 o'clock in the morning. Or that's when we think she fell down there. But she's going to have a story to tell about how she got there. But
three things they're trying to do there. You heard about the lubricant, trying to put that on her skin so she can slide off that cinder block. And also the equipment they use, that's reserved for earthquakes in the area of Portland when they arise. But the airbag philosophy, to blow up the airbag to keep the cinder block and the wall separated, to give her just a little bit of a nudge so she can slide her body out of there. And
it
looks like
really
they're almost
to see how much she's participating in this. I mean, she is trying to literally push herself out. She seems to be in good shape, which is a great sign. Given how small it is, she probably slid very slowly into that area. Oh my gosh, there she is. There. She is.
She's home.
Unbelievable. Look at her. Oh my gosh. What on earth? What a crazy story, huh?
Unbelievable. There was an eyewitness. Her name is Kia King. We had listened to her a bit earlier today. She said the woman still had her purse with her, and she's the one who heard the cries for help early in the morning. That must have been middle of the night, Portland time. She saw the woman trying to climb out of the space, but as she was holding on, she lost her grip. She started to panic, and you can understand why. She let go and then fell down to the condition where she has been for the last 4.5 hours.
She is hugging somebody there. We heard earlier that her husband was on the scene, and that's her husband. Big kiss. What?
And he came because the fire department wanted to give her more support, obviously, with her.
Oh my gosh.
With her trying to be extricated for this long a time. Congratulations, Portland Fire Department gets our play of the day.
They absolutely do. What an amazing moment that was. What a story. You don't see that every day. We'll be right back in America's Newsroom, Portland, Oregon.
What's going to happen next?